Hello everyone, welcome to my channel, Cooking with Sister Linda. So today we're going to be doing a carrot cake. But first, let's say a word of prayer. Dear Heavenly Father, we truly thank you for this blessed day. We thank you for allowing us to see another day, Lord God, to breathe another breath. Lord God, we thank you for everything that we need to make it through this life, Lord God. That we don't have, we ask that you and trust that you will supply us with it. Lord God, I ask that you bless that this be the best carrot cake that has ever been cooked in life. In Jesus' name I pray, amen. Yes, I said that. Okay, so what we have here are my ingredients for my carrot cake. And so I've already put my 2 cups of flour here. I have my cinnamon here, my salt, my baking powder, my nutmeg, and I have my baking soda. Here I have 4 eggs. I have 3 cups of carrots. I have a cup of oil, and I have a cup of granulated sugar and a cup of brown sugar. And then I have my vanilla extract here. And so I'm also going to be doing my own frosting, and so we'll get to that later. I may record that, I may not, but we'll see. Okay, so first what we're going to do is we're going to start by sifting our ingredients. And so this is all of my dried ingredients. I'm just going to put it in here. And I'm going to sift that. Get it all in there. And once you get it in and sift it, you still can mix it. Set that aside. So I have 4 eggs. You can use 3, you can use 4. It just depends on, you know, how rich you want your cake to be and what size your eggs are. Mine's were like 4 small eggs, so I use 4. If you have large eggs, I would suggest that you use 3. But it's up to you. Now, carrot cake is easy to make. It's one of those desserts that you make by trial and error. You know, you try it out. The first one don't come out right, try it again until you get it right. Don't sleep on the brown sugar, because the brown sugar gives your cake moisture. So, I'm gonna mix that some more. And I have 3 cups of shredded carrots. Now you can buy your carrots already shredded, but I wouldn't prefer it, because you know when they have stuff like that in the store, it's not as fresh, and then it's kind of thick too. I don't like thick carrots in my carrot cake. So when you shred it yourself, you can make it as fine as you want to make it. And so now what I'm going to do is beat my eggs. My mom made cakes and pies. I'm telling y'all, the secret to your cakes and pies coming out really, really delicious is to beat your eggs separately first. You will not regret it. So now I'm going to take this bowl and put my eggs in there. And then I'm going to put my sugar. I think I'm going to go on and do this. All of it's not going to go in there, but what the heck. Also, I'm going to be putting pecans in my pecan cake. I mean, not pecan cake. I'm thinking about pecan pie. I'm going to put pecans in there, and I've already put those in the oven, and so they can roast. And so you roast them for about 10 minutes. It doesn't take long. That's enough. I'm not going to keep playing with that, so I'll empty the rest of that out of there. Mix it up. Make sure you have all the clumps out. So I'm going to mix my oil in here, and I use a cup of oil. Usually I would just play this all by ear, but for the sake of doing the video, I'm using measurements. So I'm going to use a teaspoon of vanilla extract. In there. And so I'm going to mix that. Get this out the way. So now I'm going to mix it all up. Okay, so I have my oven already on 350, and so what I'm going to do is I'm going to put some of my dry ingredients in here, not all of it, just some of it, and I'm going to work it in. Just mix it some. It's good to mix a little at a time in there. That way it don't cake up, because it'll cake up and you want to make sure that you get it all blended in real good. Take it slow and easy. see how it tastes. Oh my goodness. Jesus, that's good. So, I'm gonna mix more of my dry batter again. That doesn't need anything. It is good. To the side. Okay, so now I'm going to add some of my pecans in there. Not a whole lot. Well, maybe. It's been a while since I did a carrot cake. So now I'm going to add my carrots, and this is 3 cups, so but you add whatever you want to add to yours. It just depends, to each his own. And so I'm just going to fold this in, not really just mix it. And there you have it. That's my carrot cake. And I'm using 2 9-inch cake pans. Now some people I know y'all see that it's dripping, but I'm gonna clean it up. It doesn't matter. It's just me. Put pineapple. Some people put walnuts in theirs. Some people use, don't use nutmeg. Me personally, I love the taste that nutmeg gives my desserts. My mom used it a whole lot, and I find it to be really delicious. It just gives your dessert that zing that it needs. Y'all, this is going to be good. You hear me? Sister Linda, do not play. Look at that. And you take those pecans, and plus I roasted them. Jesus. I'm just going to put a little more of this carrot in there. Because I really don't think I need 3 cups. For some reason, I don't know. It just seems like it's a lot this time. But, all right. Y'all see that? All my dry ingredients got mixed in really good. My oil. I put an ingredient in here that y'all didn't see me do, so I'm not going to tell y'all everything. My secret. Okay, so I'm going to clean this off, and then I'm going to get my 9-inch pans, and we're going to get it in our pans. Okay, so now we have our pans here that I've already battered. And so we're going to distribute this evenly. Start at the middle of your pan. Do a little in one. And maybe I can give this one a little bit more. And then side in the middle of this one. I'm going to try to get it as even as possible. And I think I can put some more in this one. And I will put the ingredients in the description box. And so you just want to make sure it's distributed evenly. Voila! That's my carrot cake. I'm going to get these in the oven. And so now I am going to do my cream cheese frosting. So I'll take y'all along with me as I do that. I hope these are even. Okay, so I've taken my cakes out of the oven. And I used this fork to make sure it was done all the way through. It is moist. It's done, and so I'm gonna let these cool, and after they cool I will add my frosting. Okay, so now I'm going to make my cream cheese frosting. And so I'm going to start off with my 8 ounces of cream cheese. Well, should I do my butter first? I think I'm gonna do my butter first. I'll do my butter first. So I'm using a stick of butter. And I'm going to mix this until I get it creamy soft. And then I'll put in my cream cheese. So let's start with butter. Turn it down. Okay, see how nice and creamy I got that? So in order to make my cream cheese frosting, what I use is my 8 ounce stick of cream cheese. I use a teaspoon of vanilla extract, and I also use a teaspoon of lemon juice. Yep, and a stick of butter. So let's add my cream cheese. Sometimes I do this different. Sometimes I use whipping cream with this. Sometimes it just depends on what I'm making and what I have a taste for. Because sometimes I use sour cream. Just depends on what I want at the time. So I cook a lot, but if you look at any of my videos, you would notice that I don't cook a lot of desserts. That's because I don't need the weight. So let me go ahead. I'm gonna put my and where's my vanilla? Just a teaspoon is all I need. All right, let's get it in. So I'm going to add my powdered sugar. This is 3 cups. And so I sifted this. And so I'm going to add a little at a time. Because I don't want it to fly all over the place. Okay. Okay, so here's my finished cake. So I've frosted the top, the bottom layer, the top layer, the sides, And I've also put my pecans around the side. And so that's my carrot cake. I hope y'all enjoyed the video. Please like, comment, subscribe, and share. Thanks. Cream frosting is delicious. You can taste the pecans. You can taste the carrots. It's just delicious. You can taste your cinnamon in there. I love it. The nutmeg. It's really good. This is really good. Mmm, that is delicious. Y'all don't toast your pecans before you put it on your carrot cake. You need to start doing it. You can taste the pecans, the carrots, your cinnamon, your nutmeg. You can just taste all that flavor in there. It's so good, and I love frosting, so I'm trying to get the frosting. It's delicious, y'all.